Welcome to my channel Skilltone. In this tutorial, I am going to discuss about how correlation and correlation matrix can be useful for data science and machine learning. We are using Jupyter Notebook in Python for demonstrating the analysis of correlation and correlation matrices. Also, we will try to explain how a scatter plot can be done through this Jupyter Notebook using NumPy, Pandas and Matplotlib command. Okay, so let's get started. Today I am going to start with creating a new Python notebook name. I can give this name as a demo correlation matrix tutorial. I rename this one. Now I'm going to upload my data which I already created. I just want to show you the data that I have created in my desktop in the pandas folder, and you can see this is a macro data of Bangladesh. As an example, I created in my Excel file. This is not an Excel file, it is a CSV file where I mention the year. You can see the number of years. I can just highlight it. You can see the number of years here, almost from 2011 until 2018. The exports, GDP of the country, GDP meaning real GDP, exports, the percentage of GDP, inflation and unemployment rate. So this is my data which I created earlier as an example and want to demonstrate in today's lecture. So let's get started without wasting any time to upload this data into our Jupyter notebook. So what I have to do is, first I need to see where I created my notebook. Here is a notebook, demo correlation matrix tutorial. So those who are interested to know about how I created Jupyter notebook and where did I get this information using the Anaconda, I would strongly recommend you to look at my previous videos about Jupyter notebook using in Python. I will share this link here so you can watch it in your own time, so you can learn more how to come up to this Jupyter notebook area. So let's get started. I want to open I want to upload a file which is already there in the macro data. So I select the notebook, select the data and click open, and you can see here the upload version is there. The file is already there. I just want to show you how it works in your case for the first time. So this is how you upload the file in the Jupyter notebook for analysis or to show you the correlation matrix. Now I would like to import some packages for analyzing of the correlation in Python. So I have to start with the pandas. So import pandas as pd, import pandas as pd. Then I need to import matplotlib for plotting the scatter plot and other plotting. This is a very good package for plotting, just like the ggplot in software R. I will demonstrate in the next part 5 how we can do it in the R, the same thing in R software, but today I'm showing at in the Jupyter notebook using Python platform. So matplotlib dot py plot as plt. So Python will understand, or Jupyter will understand, that this matplotlib, we are using plt as a short format for using it later on when we upload and command the Python for any correlation scatter plot diagram analysis. Now again we have to import another package which is called the cbond package. Cbond package is useful for any type of data science analysis using correlation regression or any type of analysis like linear regression, logistic regression, correlation matrix, all that. These are all important software packages for Python to understand your correlation matrices. So another one, and the last one, is importing NumPy. I already explained you what is NumPy. NumPy is the foundation of the pandas framework. So I also have to import numpy as np. So these are our packages that I want to upload. Now I want to upload the data, so I need to use the data frame. So this is the data frame. In the previous, the way I showed you in the last video, you can also watch my last video on how to import the data into the Python Jupyter notebook. So pd.rad, since it is a CSV file, so I'm going to use the term CSV. Okay, then within bracket desktop, the location of my file desktop slash pandas slash the name of the data, macro data. Since it is a CSV file, I just want to put the CSV, and the bracket is closed. So we already uploaded the data. Let's see the data is there or not. Enter, shift enter. We will see the data frame. Okay, there is a mistake in the data frame. I guess you can see here the D is the capital letter D, therefore the error comes. So it should be small letter. Now I try again and you see the data is already there. So now you understand from this mistake that if you change the notation or the capital letter or small letter, case sensitivity is there for Python Jupyter notebook. So be careful about the case sensitivity. This is a one learning outcome from this mistake. So now we have the data. Now my dear learners, you can see here that the data are up until column 8, but there are few things like NaN and unnamed columns and NaN rows are there. You see, now we have to delete those unnamed column and unnamed rows from the our data set. So how can we delete it? Very important, because in real life you are going to have a large data set where you will find out a lot of unnamed data and unnamed rows that you need to delete from your Python notebook, from Python analysis when you do it. So how we can do it? Now we can see when we press it, drop, you can see here from this command, columns, call for call in data frame dot columns, if unnamed column. After this command, we do not have any unnamed column under our data set. Now still we have some that NaN row, you can see in this particular row. So we want to delete that as well. So how can we delete the NaN row? So what we have to do, data frame, again we can have to give you a command dot apply. This is our command for deleting these files. It is very important when we have large data set. Usually in the data science we need to use a large data set. In that case we have some missing variables and as well as some information that will not contain the value in the row. In that case you need to use this command to clean up your data. Okay, so I hope you understand why I am doing that. So you need to use this one. So what we have to do is within bracket, okay, so this is the command, and then we use again data frame. Data frame is equal to dot Ropna, sorry, within bracket, okay, print data frame. So we can see now, my dear learners, you can see here there is no unlike here, this column contains the none or missing values, but here there is no missing value. So this is a complete data set without having unnamed column and missing row numbers. So this is a very complete package. So this is the second step you have to do before doing any big data analysis, okay, for cleaning part. Now we jump into our analysis of correlation analysis. So we can, okay, now that we delete our unnamed column and unnamed rows, now we use the Python seaborn library for drawing the scatter plot. Remember my dear learners, for any machine learning process, before we do any prediction we need to know the relationship. Without knowing the relationship, the exact relationship, we cannot predict the model variables well. So before we go to the regression, we need to do some correlation analysis, and correlation and scatter plot is the best way to understand the relationship between the two variables. So using the seaborn library, we can command ax, this is the seaborn library command for scatter plot diagram, SNS, which is already we uploaded in our library, then scatter plot, we have to define our variable. So x variable is our exports, okay. Then our y variable is our GDP, okay. And then we have our data that we are using, DF, the data frame, okay. If we want to use the color, you can use any color. I like the red, so you can use blue. You can use the green, no matter which color you like, you can of course give it a try. Okay, so once you've done it, you know the Python executing command, shift enter, and you can see, wow, beautiful scatter plot diagram is given here. So in this particular diagram, you can easily see that there is an inverse relationship between GDP and export in Bangladesh over the year starting from 2011 to 2018. In economic sense, it actually give a very interesting insight, which we will discuss in some other tutorial, that the relationship should be positive, but here we can see that the export and the GDP relationship is the negative. Our main objective here is to plot the scatter plot using the data available online, and we select Bangladesh from year 2011 to 2018 to show you the export and GDP data, and plot you through this using this seaborn scatter plot library package. So this is how you can draw the scatter plot. You can use any color to show your scatter plot diagram. Now, my dear learners, we can go and see how we can use the correlation between these two variables. To find out the correlation between these two variables, we need to define first data, then we can see the data frame that we are using at the moment. And then we can use our variable export, export, okay. Then our y variable GDP, okay. So this is our variable that we want to use in our library, okay. Now we are using correlation matrix, so we can say data frame dot co RR4. We are using method. The most widely used method is the Pearson one for correlation, for probabilistic model or parametric modeling. We use this method, and wow, you can see here by Python executive command, shift and enter, we can find the correlation between export and GDP. And you can see there is a high negative correlation between these two variables. So, my dear learners, this is what we have today. And you can use the color coding. You can see, instead of giving R, maybe we can use, let's say, G, and let's see what will happen. You can see here the color is changed. Now it is green color. The scatter plot is showing you green color. Okay, so this is what we have in this tutorial, how to analyze and plot scatter diagram and correlation in Jupyter Notebook using Python platform. You can always use as many variables as you want from this export GDP. We can use unemployment, inflation, and accordingly we can using Pearson or Kendall method to find out the correlation in Python. Next video, I will show you how we can do the same thing in RStudio.